All right, I'm going to show you how to set up a click, a metronome within MainStage 3. There's a couple of different ways that it can be done. One is by using the playback module within MainStage and dragging in an audio file. So if you have custom sounding click tracks that you want to use, that is another way. But I'm not going to touch on that. I'm actually going to show you how to set up and use the internal metronome, which I actually really like, and the drummers I work with enjoy it. The two things we have to do to get set up is, first of all, we have to set the output of the built-in metronome. So to do that, we'll go up here to our MainStage preferences. And the first tab, general, you'll see there's a metronome setting under here, and there's an output. So you select the output of your output device that you're using. If you have more than one or two, all your channels will show up here, and you can select the individual channels that you want your metronome to be fed out of. And you can also adjust the volume if you need it a little less or a little bit more. You can do that here. So that's the first thing we have to do, set up our output. Now we can close this window. Now what we need to do is, at the concert level, select Untitled Concert, because this is a new concert I've opened up here. We're going to go to the Layout tab, and we need to add two buttons that will allow us to control the metronome. It'll do two things we can control, is the tap tempo and an off and an on button. So simply I just use a real simple button here. Your layout might be a little different. Whatever works for you is totally cool. And so now we've got our two buttons. Now we're going to go back to the Edit tab, switch to Edit mode. And now we're going to assign these buttons to what we want them to do. So the first button, we're going to select the first one right here in the window. And you'll see we have unmapped attributes here. So we're going to go to the Actions tab. Then scroll down and you're going to see tap tempo. And now we've got it. Now that button will put the tempo at whatever you tap into that. Now the second button, we'll select the second button and again go to the Actions folder. We're going to scroll down and select Metronome. And that will automatically now use that button to turn the metronome on and off. So if we go to performance and we can test our tap, we can see that it's working. And if we turn the metronome on, there we go. We got our metronome. We'll turn that off for now. So now the next part is you want to have each patch have its own tempo value. So what we can do is we can take this and you select, I'm going to make more patches. Now these patches can also be songs, which I happen to use them as songs, so I'm going to rename them Song 1, Song 2, and Song 3. So we go to the first patch. You'll notice now at the patch level, we're not in the concert level, we're on the patch level, we have three tabs under our patch inspector. You're going to select attributes and you'll see the second box down, change tempo 2. So this is where you'll enter a tap enter a tempo for the patch. And when you select this patch, the tempo changes to this value. So you want to make sure that box is checked. And now that it's checked, you can actually adjust these with the up and down arrows. You can use the slider or you can actually double click and just type it in. So now what you're going to do is go to each patch and do the same thing. So select song number 2, check the box, set my tempo. Go to my next patch, check the box, adjust my tempo. So you want to make sure, like with everything, is you save that. I'm not going to save it because it's new and I'm not going to use this. But that will save your settings. So now if we go to performance mode, go to song number 1, you'll see every time we select a new patch, it adjusts the tempo accordingly. So you're able to turn that metronome on. And when you change to the next patch, it changes accordingly with you. And of course, because we set this up at the beginning, It'll be sending that click out whatever output channel in the preferences panel that you adjusted it to. So that's it. That's how you do that. And the other cool thing is within main stage, you can actually take these buttons and program them to an external controller. So you could actually have your tap tempo adjusted by a controller, a keyboard, or a drum machine, whatever MIDI controller that you are using. Or if you're a guitar player, you have a foot pedal. So you can turn your metronome off and on depending on how you use it. But that's it. That's how it's done. Hope it helps.